Good morning, my dear students. In the last session, you have learnt about various types of microbes and their biological significations. Today, we are going to know about harmful microbes. Some microorganisms are harmful in many ways. Some cause diseases in human beings, plants, and animals. Such diseases of the microorganisms are called pathogens. Microbial diseases that can spread from an infected person to a healthy person through air, through water, food, or physical contact. These are all called communicable diseases. Robert Koch discovered the bacterium Bacillus anthracis, which causes anthrax disease.
Communicable diseases. Our health is affected by many infectious diseases that spread from one person to another. These are caused by bacteria, viruses, and other microorganisms called pathogens. Some of these diseases are explained here. Airborne disease. Many infectious diseases spread by pathogens carried by air. When an infected person coughs or sneezes, tiny droplets of moisture that may contain the pathogens are expelled into the air. People breathing in these droplets are likely to get infected. Waterborne diseases. Consumption of infected water causes diseases like typhoid, dysentery, diarrhea, jaundice, etc. Pathogens of these diseases are mainly introduced into water bodies through untreated sewage and industrial effluents. Food-borne diseases. Contaminated food also transmits infectious diseases like typhoid, tuberculosis, dysentery, jaundice, and food poisoning.
Now, let us know about some common human diseases caused by microorganisms. Tuberculosis is caused by bacteria called tuberculosis bacillus. Mode of transmission is through air. Preventive measures, general, keep the patient in complete isolation. Keep the person, belongings of the patient away from those of the others. Vaccination to be given a suitable age. Then measles is caused by virus. The mode of transmission is air. Chickenpox is also caused by virus. The mode of transmission is air. And this picture shows the virus, varicella zoster virus. And now you can see this picture about cholera caused by bacteria. The mode of transmission is water or through food. The bacteria is Vibrio cholerae. Then the other human disease is typhoid. The bacteria is Salmonella typhi. The preventive measure, maintain personal hygiene and good sanitary habits. Consume properly cooked food and boiled drinking water. Vaccination should be taken. The whole world is threatened by four diseases. First stands malaria, and second is malnutrition, and third one is HIV and hepatitis A. The other fourth one is, nowadays we are facing COVID-19. This patient is suffering from hepatitis A. Causative microorganism is virus, hepatitis B virus. This virus also affects hepatitis A, which comes under Baltimore group, dsDNA RT species. The mode of transmission is water. So preventive measures, drinking water, vaccination. Now you can see a malarial patient. It is caused by the bite of female Anopheles mosquito. This female Anopheles mosquito injects plasmodium into the human blood and causes malaria. The symptoms of malaria: systematic symptoms, high fever, back pain, profuse sweating, in the lungs, dry cough, in the muscles, severe fatigue and ache, and the skin, chills, sweating. Central, the brain part, severe headache, the spleen becomes enlarges. In the stomach, you feel nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and sometimes blood in the stools.
Today's topic is malaria. Malaria is a life-threatening disease. It's typically transmitted through the bite of an infected Anopheles mosquito. Infected mosquitoes carry the Plasmodium parasite. When this mosquito bites you, the parasite is released into your bloodstream. Causes: malaria can occur if a mosquito infected with the Plasmodium parasite bites you. There are four kinds of malaria parasites that can infect humans: Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale, Plasmodium malariae, and Plasmodium falciparum. Plasmodium falciparum causes a more severe form of the disease, and those who contract this form of malaria have a higher risk of death. An infected mother can also pass the disease to her baby at birth. This is known as congenital malaria. Malaria is transmitted by blood, so it can be transmitted through an organ transplant, a transfusion, use of shared needles or syringes. Signs and symptoms: a malaria infection is generally characterized by recurrent attacks with the following signs and symptoms: moderate to severe shaking chills, high fever, sweating. Other signs and symptoms may include headache, vomiting, diarrhea. Malaria signs and symptoms typically begin within a few weeks after being bitten by an infected mosquito. However, some types of malaria parasites can lie dormant in your body for up to a year. Diagnosis: blood tests can show the presence of the parasite and help tailor treatment by determining whether you have malaria. Which type of malaria parasite is causing your symptoms? If your infection is caused by a parasite resistant to certain drugs? Whether the disease is affecting any of your vital organs? Some blood tests can take several days to complete, while others can produce results in less than 15 minutes. Treatment: the types of drugs and the length of treatment will vary depending on which type of malaria parasite you have, the severity of your symptoms, your age, whether you're pregnant. Medications: the most common antimalarial drugs include chloroquine, quinine sulfate, hydroxychloroquine, mefloquine, combination of atovaquin and proguanil. The history of anti-malarial medicine has been marked by a constant struggle between evolving drug-resistant parasites and the search for new drug formulations. In many parts of the world, for instance, resistance to chloroquine has rendered the drug ineffective. Thank you for watching our video. Please do not forget to like and share the video. Also, please subscribe to the channel to stay updated on our latest videos.
My dear students, several microorganisms, not only disease causes in human plants, but also in other animals. For example, anthrax is a dangerous human cattle disease caused by bacterium Bacillus anthracis. Foot and mouth disease of cattle is also caused by virus. Now, let us know about diseases causing microorganisms in plants. Several microorganisms cause disease in plants like wheat, rice, potato, sugarcane, orange, etc. Citrus canker is caused by bacteria. This disease causes in citrus family fruits like lemon, orange, etc. And in this picture, you can see the rusting of wheat caused by microorganism fungi. The mode of transmission is air, seeds. And you can see the cucumber is suffering from CMV, cucumber mosaic virus. In this picture, the upper part is infected, but the whole inner content is destroyed by viruses. This is cucumber mosaic virus. The species is IF-15. Now, let us concentrate on prevention measures. How the disease can be prevented. Protect yourself from your family.
In this video, we're going to look at how we can tell when a plant has a disease. And we'll also cover the defenses that plants have to stop them from getting diseases in the first place. Just like humans, plants can catch diseases from a range of microorganisms, including fungi, bacteria, and viruses, but also from larger organisms like insects. They can also get deficiency diseases, which can happen if they don't get enough essential minerals like nitrates or magnesium ions. For example, nitrates are needed for making proteins and therefore for growth. So plants without sufficient nitrates often get stunted growth, where they don't grow as much as they should. Magnesium ions, on the other hand, are needed for making chlorophyll, which in turn is needed for photosynthesis. So plants with a magnesium deficiency often suffer chlorosis from lack of chlorophyll and have yellow leaves. Some other symptoms that diseased plants might have include abnormal growths or lumps, malformed stems or leaves, patches of decay, or spots of discoloration on their leaves. In some cases, you might even be able to see the organism responsible, particularly if they're fairly big, like aphids or spider mites. When trying to diagnose disease, the easiest thing to do is to take basic observations and try to match the symptoms that you see to a disease listed in a gardening manual or a website. If that fails, though, then you could send a sample of the diseased plant to a plant pathologist, which is somebody who specializes in plant disease, and will be able to do more detailed testing. For example, they could take a tissue sample and then look at it under a microscope so that they can see the problems in more detail. They could also look for unique antigens that come from particular pathogens, perhaps using monoclonal antibodies. Or even better, they could run DNA tests that look for pathogen DNA. A more basic method is trial and error. For example, if your plant has some yellow leaves, so you think it has a magnesium deficiency, then you could just give it some magnesium and see if that fixes it. Or if you think it's a fungal disease, then you could spray it with antifungal chemicals and see what happens. The benefit of this technique is that you can just try one thing, and if it doesn't work, you try something else. The last thing we need to cover are plant defenses, which can be split between physical, chemical, and mechanical. Physical defenses act to physically prevent the entry of pathogens, and include a waxy cuticle, which often covers the leaves and stems of plants, the cellulose cell walls around each individual cell, and the layers of dead cells that some plants have around their stem, like bark. Meanwhile, chemical defenses refers to actual chemicals that the plants can secrete. These could be antimicrobial substances.
Stay healthy. While traveling, use masks and sanitizers. Prevent STD by following precautionary measures. STD means sexually transmitted diseases. Prevent plant diseases in just 6 simple steps. Grow disease resistance or tolerant plants. Match your plants to your growing conditions. Avoid a wet environment and prone to improve air circulation. Control garden pests, diseases, transmitters. Use sanitizer tools and keep a clean growing environment. Destroy seeds, plant materials upon detection. My dear students, I hope you have understood about harmful microbes and its effects. Now, please take down home assignment. Thank you. We will meet in the next sessions.